It's been 4 weeks since devastating floods swept through northern New South Wales and southeast Queensland, wiping out countless homes and destroying livelihoods. Some businesses are now back up and running, gearing up for the return of visitors over the Easter break, but others are not so lucky. We're joined by Lance Burrow and Mick McCone at the Brecky Creek Hotel in Brisbane, Lismore Mayor Steve Krieg. Let's go to you first, Steve. What's your message to people considering visiting Lismore in these coming weeks?
Yeah, good morning and thanks for having me. It's really hard to encourage people to come here at the moment. We've got probably 98% of our businesses still affected and still not open, and there's a long road before they reopen again. We also don't have any motels or accommodation at the moment. We can't house our own people at the moment, so it's really hard for people that want to come into Lismore as a tourist. One of the things that I've been thinking about, though, is, you know, we have ecotourism and different things like that. Maybe in a couple of weeks we can start the tradie tourism and tradies who are looking for a bit of a holiday can bring their caravans, stay in a park and do a bit of work while they're here.
And help out. For people that aren't tradies, is there anything they can do to help out, though?
Oh, there's so much that people can do. You know, we've got towns close to us like Byron and Ballina who do have motels and accommodation up and running. You know, Blues Fest is on at Easter. Feel free to throw in a pair of work boots or gum boots and come in and lend a hand if you're in the region. We'd love to see you. We just don't have any accommodation for you at the moment.
Yeah, that seems like something down the track. Lance, the good news at Brecky Creek is that although you were affected by the floods, you're now back up and running.
Yeah, it's been a tough 3 weeks, but yeah, you know, we started trading last Friday. We finally finished the second stage of opening yesterday with opening at Spanish Garden, and it's been, you know, it was a tough time. The staff really helped out, the community really helped out. We're really lucky because we're a bigger business, so we could pull resource. We lost all our kitchens, all our gaming machines. We could pull resource to get the pub back in action. And we've got great partnerships with companies like Great Northern that assist us to get to where we are today. So, yeah, we're super excited at the moment to be able to get back and trade and do what we actually do.
Yeah, we're seeing pictures of the flooding at the pub. It's remarkable that you are back up and running. Mick, do you know how many pubs have been affected across Queensland and northern New South Wales?
Yeah, look, we know of about 52 pubs that have been severely affected by the weather and that need the support. So, you know, all the way up from northern New South Wales into southeast Queensland. So, yeah, just 52 that are really struggling, need support.
And in so many places, pubs can be the cornerstone of the community. Talk us about the recovery effort and what it looks like and how long will it take?
Yeah, well, look, it's going to take a long time, you know, like these businesses, you know, to get back up and running, they need immediate support, so they need help from, you know, businesses like Great Northern. But, you know, it's going to take a while for the community to come back in and feel comfortable going to the pub again. But I just urge everyone to go in and go and have a meal. Go and sit down and you know, talk to the publicans and just get back in the doors and really help them out that way, because people can help immediately. So that's what we're urging people to do, and doing things like the flood relief effort. You know, we've got major campaign going on from the 30th to the 3rd of April, where people can go in and go and grab a beer and grab a Great Northern and know that's supporting their local pubs and the flood relief effort immediately.
Yeah, beer, a steak, a smile and get things back up and running. Look, we really appreciate your time. Wish you all the best, all three of you, as you move forward with what is going to be a clean-up that takes months and probably years, but hopefully everyone can get in behind you. Great to speak to you this morning, Belinda.